The number is 12.8 million. That's the total revenue that Aave did in November 2025. That's also 3 times more revenue than the rest of its competitors combined. Being number one, how else would they grow in the market? Learn more about Aave and their V4 upgrade to slash even more fees in this episode of the AthenaX White Paper. In this episode, we'll cover what is Aave's competitive edge apart from the market? Does its tokenomics matter now that it's fully unlocked? And what does the V4 upgrade mean for everybody? In 2016, Stani Kalitroff from Finland was studying law when he first became interested in Ethereum. His idea? What if you could remove the middlemen like banks and provide more value to users? One ICO and one prototype later, Aave was released on Ethereum in January 2020. Aave positions itself as a scalable, open source, non-custodial liquidity markets with variable rates. Simply put, you have controls over your own funds and you deposit and borrow assets with Aave in exchange for interest. But the reason why they're so popular is because Aave V1 created the flash loan for arbitrages. These are uncollateralized loans that are issued and repaid within 12 seconds. Why 12 seconds? Because that's the amount of time that it takes for Ethereum to complete one transaction block before the next block is mined. In 2020, the strategy worked like this. Borrow millions from Aave, buy tokens that are lower on Uniswap, and sell the same tokens that are higher on SushiSwap, and then watch the money get printed into your account in 12 seconds. The strategy still exists today, but it's a lot harder to execute given the maturity of the space and also price oracles. Leading into the first mover advantage, Aave continues to lead innovation, introducing different product upgrades such as their debt delegation A tokens in V2 and their Go stablecoins in V3. Apart from innovation, Aave also has an impressive track record of having no major security exploits in protecting its users' funds, placing them as a vanguard for funds and earning user trust. The upcoming V4 upgrade is highly anticipated, as it promises even cheaper borrowing rates and more efficient liquidity for the protocol. But more importantly, they continue to introduce new markets that arbitrageurs can participate in with flash loans. The V4 upgrade also aligns with Ethereum's Fusaka, using a hub and spoke model for liquidity management, which honestly is a convoluted way to say better load balancing for supply and demand. So let's look at the Aave token, the glue that kind of holds everything together. There is a total supply of 16 million Aave, with 95% of that in circulation and the remainder 5% is burned. The Aave tokens have been fully unlocked since 2021 and has introduced staking for token incentives. Staking Aave enables fee discounts on flash loans up 20% on borrowing. They also provide earnings from liquidation penalties. And most importantly, they also provide you voting rights on proposals to essentially guide and lead the direction of the protocol. Post April 2025, the protocol allocated about 50 million of its treasury revenue to annually buy back Aave for burning and distribution in a governance vote. Protocol revenue has already hit $86 million year to date and is funding the ongoing buybacks despite the market dips. So where does Aave's revenue source come from? There are three. The first one is borrowing, which makes up 60%, flash loans make up 25%, and the liquidation penalties make up 10%. There are also other minor sources like stablecoin peg mechanisms or cross-chain portal fees in V3, and those make up for the 5%. Now, the 5% may not look like much now, but I'll get into this in a bit and why I think this is going to increase when V4 arrives. So on the tech side, Aave's core tech is its pool-based AMM for lending. Suppliers feed the shared liquidity pools and borrowers draw instantly at utilization rates. Naturally, the busier the market, the higher the borrow rates are. The key feature are its flash loans, which charges anywhere between 5 to 9 bips to fuel arbitrage opportunities. Also included in the tech is a risk engine called efficiency mode, which dynamically adjusts liquidation levels based on the borrowed asset. For example, the USD peg stablecoins, which are considered lower risk, they benefit from a higher LTV or loan to value ratio for whatever that these guys want to use it for. Lastly, under its tech, there are different product versions, which essentially is a direction for Aave to improve capital efficiencies across the fragmented blockchains. V1 added flash loans. In V2, we had A tokens, which were essentially yield-bearing tokens, and you were able to delegate or tokenize that on one blockchain. And V3 added portals and vaults, which essentially allowed you to transfer these yield-bearing tokens through multiple blockchains, through the canonical bridges, and also boosting flash loan activity. The upcoming V4 upgrade changes the model a bit, and it's quite a bit of a bold move. On the efficiency side, V4 reduces fees for flash loans, which benefits the users at the cost of reducing revenue for the protocol. V4 also adds automated risk silos, intending to reduce bad debt to preserve the Aave treasury. Now, on the revenue side, which I think is key here, V4 adds customizable new markets, which has been left vague in the documentation. And this is where I want to theory craft a little bit and take a look at why this matters. For Aave to grow even further, they need to increase the utilization and also the number of markets that they're involved in. Since August, they've been doing that with the institutional RWA market. To better service these markets, V4 would be used to discover the scalable parameters and the definitions of what a customizable market is. Aave launched Horizon in August to capitalize on a growing RWA segment, which has surpassed $500 million in total market size. The core function of the Horizon market is to allow users to supply permissioned tokenized RWAs as collateral while borrowing Aave's native stablecoin, GO, or GHO. Earlier in November, the VanEck Treasury Fund announced they were placing $93 million worth of RWAs onto Horizon to collateralize for GO. Now, 100% of this minting fees goes back into the Aave token treasury, which kind of, when you think about it, places Aave as sort of a central bank and treasury reserve model, but because of the flash loans, they're a lot more productive. So let's go back to the on-chain RWAs. Can these on-chain RWAs be traded on the secondary market? The answer to that is no. V4 has strictly said that RWAs, to stay compliant, must be for collateral use only and cannot be traded. The risks that Aave faces fall mainly to two categories, the utilization risk and the security risk. A low borrow utilization rate simply means less revenue for Aave. And conversely, a high borrow utilization makes it simply too expensive for arbitragers to take on a flash loan. To offset this risk, Aave will need to essentially service new on-chain markets. And in theory, these new serviceable markets will allow its users to find new arbitrage strategies and thus generating more revenue for Aave as it goes back into the flywheel. The next level of risk for Aave is its smart contract risk. Now, post V3 updates, exploits to the smart contract are rare and they have seemed to have happened on the periphery of Aave and not with Aave directly. However, cross-chain bridges have had a long history of exposure to hacks and price manipulation attacks, so we won't completely rule that out yet. From a competition point of view, there is none. Aave leads the market with a 60% market share, holding $30 billion in TVL in comparison to MakerDAO, Morpho, and Compound's cumulative $15.8 billion. Aave also has a defensible moat in the form of revenue buybacks and its new V4 modularity to outpace its forks. Some final thoughts. So being a dominant player for 8 years, Aave is really one of those rare protocols that have stood the test of time. They've continuously improved their product offering while also maintaining the security. Its revenue surge this year really cements itself as DeFi's lending blue chip, and I would consider it as a must-have in a portfolio focused on growth. They are way ahead of the competition in terms of market share, and the constant product updates really makes it difficult to find an alternative. With the upcoming V4 integration for capital efficiency and support for the growing RWA market, I would bet on Aave as a prominent growth stock. That is all for this episode of White Paper by AthenaX. Once again, we're purely educational and not financial advice. I'll see you at the next one.